Hi there, I'm Sam from CreativeMinds. In this video, we're going to take a look at the multi-user extension for Magento. In standard Magento, each account only has one user. Our new extension allows you to create multiple user profiles within one Magento account that each have unique permissions, including read-only accounts, administrative accounts, accounts that allow users to manage and create orders, or a combination of these permissions. This is an extremely useful extension for store managers to give certain employees access to only one type of account with permissions that meet their responsibilities, while blocking certain employees from managing orders or from changing account information, for example. So let's take a look at how this extension works.
So the first thing you'll need to do after installing the extension is go to System Configuration. Then under Customers, you'll see the subheading Sub Account Configuration. And here you can decide whether or not new users need to have an email confirmation in order to create their profiles. So after installing our new multi-user extension for Magento, on your account dashboard, you'll see a new title and it says Manage Users. Here you're going to have a list of all of the different users that have been created under this individual account. And right now we have three different users and they all have unique permissions. So first here we have this employee demo account and it's a read-only account. The next user we have is a manager demo account. And this account has order creation and modify account privileges. And the third user we have here is another demo employee user. And this user is able to create orders. As an administrator, you can easily go in and edit any of these user accounts. You can change or add the user information, including first name and last name. You can add or change an email address to be associated with this user. And most importantly, you can go in and change that user's permissions. So the options we have here are a read-only user, modify account user, order creation user, or order creation and modify account user. If we go back to the manage users page, you can easily add a new user. So we're gonna add another demo account. We'll call it employee 3. You can add an email address. And we're going to give this third employee modify account permissions. Finally, we can give this user a preliminary password. And then when you click add user, an email will be sent to this user asking them to confirm their new user profile. However, even before this employee confirms their new account, as you can see, on our user list, we have employee 3 demo as a new user at the bottom. We also have the permission of modify account. So now we're going to log out of that main account and we're going to log in as one of the different users of that account. So we're going to log in as employee 1. Then we're going to go to employee 1's dashboard for this account. And because employee 1 only has a read-only account, if they attempt to go into the address book, this alert will appear and says, you don't have permission for this action. So this user cannot change any of the information in this account. They only can read it. So now we're logged in as the manager demo user. The manager user does have permission to modify the account. So they can go ahead and add new addresses and contact information. As you can see, that alert that appeared for the read-only employee demo account does not appear for the manager demo account. So now we're still in the manager demo user, and this user does have order creation permissions. So if they go to a certain product and they add it to their cart, they'll have no problem creating this order. However, if a read-only user or a modify account-only user were to try to create an order, they would be prevented from doing that.